Where's Joe?
He's working from home.
What, for how long?
Well, for a few days. He just wants me to take over until he gets back.
That's one of the benefits of knocking around with the boss's daughter, isn't it?
Jim, it's just a temporary arrangement.
Still, there are guys been here a lot longer than you, Connor.
Listen, we've got a lot of work to do if we're going to meet the completion date, so let's just get on with it, all right? Now, I want to finish the framing at the back, and then we're going to start in the internal walls, all right?
You're the boss.
Right. That's looking good. Right. That's a nice job you're doing, Jim.
Yeah, I'll finish the rest when I come back.
Come back from work? It's only 20 past 11.
Yeah, I know. I want to get to the bank before lunch.
No, that's the stuff you're supposed to do during lunch.
So why is it they call it lunch and not bank? Give me a break, will you? All I'm trying to do is beat the queues.
No, look, Jim, Messiah, it's a no-go. I mean, if I let you go off whenever you want, the others are just going to have to pick up your slack. Just work the hours Joe pays you for. All right, everyone, back to work. Got a lot to do before lunch.
Yeah, the number for Department of Immigration.
You know, the novelty will probably wear off once the baby's born.
Yeah, that's a pity, but, I mean, he makes a great vegetable lasagna, and my overalls have never looked better.
I know, but he's around all the time. It's not normal.
Yeah, no, that's the strange part, though. I actually miss having him around on site. Mm. Like, no, I mean, it's great being a boss, don't get me wrong. It's just, when it comes to people, Joe has a better knack for it.
What, like suppliers and stuff?
Suppliers, yeah, and workers.
Oh, they're not giving you a hard time already, are they?
No, it's nothing I can't handle.
Oh, that'll probably be Dad telling me to get the clothes out of the dryer. Hello? No, Mr. Scully's not here at the moment. Can I take a message? Can I ask what it's about? Sure, I'll pass that on. Bye.
Well, what's the matter?
That was the immigration department. They wanted to talk to Dad about you.
What? But why? I mean, like, I haven't done anything wrong.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I mean, I've got ages left on my working visa.
Well, there must be rules about what you can do while you're here, yeah?
Oh, are you joking? There's millions of them.
Yeah, like?
Well, I don't know. But I mean, like, I pay taxes.
Why are they calling then?
I don't know.
Listen, we should probably go through your travel documents just to make sure that you've got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, look, I'll go and get them now.
Working holiday visa holders are free to leave and re-enter the country, are free to work for the same employer for a maximum of 3 months. Connor?
What?
You're only allowed to have the same job for 3 months.
Why?
Well, I don't know. Who cares? You've been working with Dad for so much longer than that.
Yeah.
That's what it is then.
Well, maybe I should just quit.
What if they lock you up or deport you
or
something?
Oh, come on, Michelle. You're exaggerating.
What am I? This is the immigration department that we're talking about.
Well, nobody told me about this stuff before.
Well, they probably didn't think that they had to, but look, it's clearly written there.
I couldn't read before whenever I got all this stuff. I just sort of took it for word of mouth.
Well, it's done now, but... who could have dubbed you in?
Well, who says anyone did?
Well, how else would they know?
Hi.
Hey.
Hi. How are you?
Good. Weren't you going to the Kennedys for dinner?
Yeah, we are. Your mother just forgot her iced tea, you know what she's like.
Oh, surprised she left home without it.
Yeah. Well, listen, you two make sure you get this kitchen nice and cleaned up. Because... oh, it's pretty clean. Well done.
Why didn't you tell them?
Because it's too soon, don't you think?
No, they're just going to call back.
Well, until they do, we've got some time to figure out something.
Hey.
Hi, Teddy.
Hi.
Hey, nice duck.
Have you got a minute?
Yeah, come on in.
Thanks. I'm doing this assignment at school on immigration, and I just wanted to fire a few legal questions at you, if that's okay.
Yeah, what's going on here?
Well, funny you should talk about migration. That's what this little fella's about to do.
Hmm? Oh, you send him away?
Yeah. His owner, Sarah, wants him in London.
Oh, poor wee fella.
We're trying to think of it as an adventure.
What do you think?
Yeah, it's really good.
So, Todi, how much do you know about working visas and that sort of thing?
Oh, not much.
Ah.
But I do know a little bit. Fire away, what do you want to know?
Okay, basically, what happens if someone breaks a condition of their working visa?
By committing a crime?
No, no, nothing like that. Just, working too much, staying too long.
Oh, well, like I said, I'm not really an expert, but, I do know the Immigration Department come down really hard on people they think's trying to rort the system.
Yeah, a mate of my brother's got caught. He got a quick trip to the airport and a one-way ticket home.
You're kidding.
No, no, he had to pay for the ticket as well, cancelled his visa, banned him for re-entering, and copped the fine as well.
This has got nothing to do with you, has it, Connor?
No. No, no, of course not.
They can't kick you out for this.
Oh, we don't know that they will.
Connor, I don't want to be left here alone without you.
Shad, you jump on the gun a bit, don't you?
Who do you reckon that is?
I don't know. Door-to-door salesman?
Could be the guy from Immigration.
Yeah, and it could not be.
And do you want to stick around and find out?
No, no, I don't.
Now, we've had a report of an Irish national working for you.
Oh, yeah, well, that'd be Conor O'Neill. Oh, but it's all right. I mean, he's got a working visa.
Well, I'm afraid it's not as simple as that, Mr. Scully. Did you get the message that I called?
No.
Last night, I spoke to a young woman. Your daughter, perhaps.
Oh, yeah, well, that'd be Shell. She's probably forgotten to tell us.
How long has Connor been working for you?
Oh, it's hard to say. 6 months, I reckon.
Oh, no, I really think it'd be more like 8, love.
Oh. What?
The conditions of a working visa in this country include not working for the same employer longer than 3 months.
Oh. Why didn't he say?
It would seem there's been a serious breach.
Well, it would be an innocent mistake.
Yes, well, he would have been clearly warned when he entered Australia. It's on all the forms he signed. The young man's looking at having his visa cancelled. Do you have an address for him?
Oh, yeah, well, he lives here, in the garage.
Urge him to call me straight away. The longer it takes, the worse it'll look for him. There's one other thing you should be aware of, Mr. Scully.
Uh-huh.
As his employer, your role in this will be investigated.
What?
Investigate? What for?
There are fines for knowingly employing illegals.
Joe Scully.
Dad, it's me.
Michelle, are you at school?
No, I had a free.
And Connor's with you, right?
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, we'll put him on.
Why?
Because he's supposed to be at work and I'm his boss.
Dad, there was a guy at our house this morning. Was he from Immigration?
Yes, he was.
What did he want?
Michelle, why didn't you tell me he'd called? A little bit of warning would have been nice.
Here, ask him if I'm in trouble.
Dad. Is Connor in trouble?
Look, Shell, tell Connor to get to work, you get to school, and we'll sort it out when you both get home.
Are they going to deport him?
Shell, look, the guy said that we'd have it all sorted out in 24 hours.
One day, that's all they're giving us.
Shell, just tell Connor to get to work.
Sorry, Dad.
Shell!
What? What did they say about one day?
That's how long it's going to take them to kick you out of the country.
What am I going to do?
Well, I don't know. You can't go back to work, that's for sure. We just need some time and we can figure this out.
Well, maybe you should phone the department, like, you know, see what's going on.
No, they might detain you or something. Hey, yeah. Let's take in your car for a drive.
Well, it's not mine yet.
Yeah, I know, but, I mean, it will be soon. That's why Stuart's giving it a roadworthy, yeah?
Yeah.
So, just think of it as a test drive. Looks like we've got a place as any.
Good for what?
Hiding you out until we know what to do.
Oh, Michelle, you've been a bit dramatic, aren't you?
What? They might put you in a detention centre.
Michelle, look, I've tried this option before, okay?
What option?
Running away. Look, it doesn't work.
We're not running away. We're buying time.
You should be at school and I should be talking about the department about this, but doing it properly.
No.
Yes.
No. Okay, once they've got you, they might put you on a plane, send you back to Ireland, and you will never be allowed back here again.
Michelle, I don't know what...
Listen, it is going to be years before I can get to Ireland. We might have one day. And then I might never see you again.
I don't know, Lenny. She didn't say much before she hung up.
Yeah, but what exactly did she say, Joe? I mean, you must have put the fear of God in them for them not to be back by now.
I did not. They'll be home in a minute, you'll see.
Yeah, they could be on a bus to Timbuktu by now.
Michelle wouldn't do that, and nor would Connor. Look, Lenny, it's about time we started trusting them.
Hey, normally I would agree with you, but when it comes to Connor, you know, Michelle can be, well, very passionate.
Len, they are probably sitting in a coffee shop somewhere, having a coffee and, well, trying to drum up the courage to call immigration.
Aren't you being just a little calm about this?
Well, there's no point in worrying. I mean, it's not the first time that, you know, Shell's had a day off school. She'll pick it up. They've just had a bit of a fright, that's all.
It just all seems so silly. I mean, why can't Connor work for you for more than 3 months? And how come you're copping a fine out of it?
Well, I should have known about the 3-month thing. I mean, rules are rules and, well, ignorance is no defence.
They can't deport him, though, can they?
To tell you the truth, I'm peeved that it's come up at all. I mean, someone's dobbed him in and I can't believe it'd be anyone on the work site.
Well, he gets along really well, though, doesn't he, with all the blokes at work?
Well, yeah, I would have said so.
You don't think, you know, like making him foreman could have got on someone's nerves a bit?
Oh, no one would take it that far, surely.
Her mobile!
I already thought of it. She left it here. Look, they'll be home soon, Lenny. They'll get hungry and, well, they'll miss my cooking.
I think that woman that signed us in actually believed that we were married.
I don't think she could either way.
This is Michelle O'Neill.
I bet if we got married, you'd actually keep your real name.
Why? What's so great about Scully?
I don't know, I just thought it was a principle.
I think I might stay Mrs. O'Neill till we go back.
And when do you suppose that's going to be, Michelle? I mean, we're in a lot of trouble, you know?
That's it.
What?
It's so obvious.
What?
I keep you in the country. Connor, will you marry me?
It's a really nice gesture, it is, but, I mean, you must know it's not possible.
Why is it not possible? Unless you don't love me anymore.
What? No, you know I love you with all my heart, I do, but, Michelle, you're 16.
So? Girls get married a lot younger than 16 in other parts of the world.
Yeah, well, this isn't all over the world. I mean, it's here, okay? I mean, here you're supposed to finish school and start a career.
I can have a career and be married. People do that these days.
Yeah, well, it wouldn't be a proper wedding. I mean, you might be devastated.
She'll be relieved. We'll be saving her a fortune.
I don't think she'd see it that way.
Listen. All that I care about right now is us being together. And if getting married to you means that it's going to keep you in the country, then I can't see a problem.
Are you really determined on it?
Well, it can't be any other way. Especially when the immigration people are trying to put us on opposite sides of the world.
Okay, all right. Oh, well, on one proviso, but...
What?
That we phone your mummy and daddy and let them know that we're okay. I mean, they must be worried sick. All right?
Well, just tell me where you are and I'll come get you. No, Michelle.
That was Michelle, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, she rang to let you know that they're okay.
Oh, good. I'm glad. I was getting worried there for a minute.
Calm down, Dad.
I am calm. Did she say where she was?
No.
Yeah, well, Michelle's always jumping in at the deep end, but Connor should have more sense. Lenny, I was thinking that, well, maybe, you know, it wouldn't hurt to give the police a call.
Yeah, but what can they do? I mean, she's 16. I mean, she hasn't been kidnapped, she's run away, and, like, Connor's in enough trouble, isn't he, without getting police involved?
Yeah, well, you know, I just thought, well... You know.
Yeah, I know.
It's hard to wait. We kind of have to, though, don't we? We have to have faith in them, love. They'll be good. They'll come back.
You know, I just can't wait till we're home here safe and sound. I'm going to rip Colin to pieces. Don't you wait too long.
I'm so sorry. My housekeeper tells me you've been waiting for hours.
No, just a little while, but that's okay. I'm Michelle, and this is my fiancé, Connor.
Now, let me guess. You're here to talk about marriage. Would that be right?
Yeah, how did you know?
Marriage is a big step to be taking when you're both so very young.
Yeah, we know, but we know our minds and we're positive that this is the right thing to do.
Yeah, it's just I want to take Michelle to the island with me, and I just think it'll be better for your marriage.
Exactly how old are you, Connor?
I'm 19, finally.
And you, Michelle?
16.
This is me.
Yeah, well, age isn't everything, is it? I mean, we've known each other for ages now, and we're in love.
Yes, I can see you are.
So will you marry us?
Of course.
That is excellent news, isn't it?
There are, however, some formalities we have to go through. You'll need a license. That will take about a month.
A month?
And since you're under 18, you'll need your parents' permission. Will this be a problem?
It's going to be a very big problem, Father, yes.
And Michelle will have to apply for permission from the court. Much better to wait a year or two and enjoy the blessings of all concerned.
No, no, you don't understand, because in a year or two, Connor won't be here.
Yeah, look, it's not a question of not cooperating. He doesn't know he's required. Now, I'll make sure he gives you a call as soon as he gets back. Yes, yeah, I do realise that, and I'll make sure Connor knows it too. Yeah, goodbye.
Immigration not happy.
Yeah, well, I'm not too happy about telling my pack a lie either.
Yeah, well, you had to ring them dead before they turned up on the doorstep. Hey, you reckon he knows that he can't keep on hiding from them now that they know about him?
It's going to become a police matter soon. Connor's lost his senses.
Yeah, or Michelle's leading him by the nose.
Yeah, well, there is that.
Oh, well, don't worry about it, Dad. They'll come back when they're ready.
Wait till you're a father.
Yeah, pigs will be flying. Are you going to work?
No, I'm going to let Jim take care of it today. I want to be here in case anything happens.
Come on, slow coach.
What? I've been waiting for you.
Sure. How's Lynn this morning?
Oh, you know, not too good. She's still in bed. I rang Gina. Just worried that all this is going to affect the baby.
Ah, it's a scully dad. It can handle a bit of stress. Mum.
See ya.
Yes, later.
I could do this if you like.
Hey, oh, no, it's okay. Well, you're having a lie down.
Yeah. Sort of doze off and have these horrible dreams.
You got to stop worrying, love. I mean, she's all right. At least we know that much.
We don't know anything.
Shell, is that you?
It's me.
Shell, where are you?
That's not important. Look, I just need to tell you something.
What do you mean it's not important? Shell, your mother has spent most of the day in bed, sick with worry, and no one here has had any sleep. What? Not important.
Look, I'm really sorry if you've been worried.
You're sorry? You're sorry? Shell, the two of you have stolen a car! I want you to get in that car and get home straight away. Shell, are you there?
I can't talk to him. He's off the planet.
Just stay calm. Ask to speak to Lynn.
Dad, I want to speak to Mum.
No, you're not speaking to your mother, Shell.
Hello, darling. Yeah, I just want to know the two of you all right?
Yeah, we're fine. Listen, I need to tell you something, but I just need you to understand, okay? Don't get angry.
Yeah, I'm listening, love.
You know how much me and Connor want to be together, but the only way that that's going to happen is if we get married, so we've decided to, but we need your permission. And you will help us, won't you?
Did you say married?
Michelle, you listen to me. You are 16 years old. You are definitely not getting married. Now, I want you home here now, young lady. Right?
Michelle, let me talk.
Michelle. Good one, Joe.
Married.
He's so impossible. He thinks he knows what's right for everyone. He doesn't understand.
Listen. Why don't we just do as he says and go home and make peace with him, please?
No, we are not going home. There has to be a way around this. There has to be.
They think that getting married is going to solve Connor's visa problem.
I suppose so.
Yeah, but it won't. I mean, you have to be married for at least 2 years, I think it is.
We're just looking for a solution, love. I just want to be together. They're in love.
I'll get it.
G'day, mate. Parcel for you.
G'day.
Just sign here for me.
Hey, here?
Yep. Alright, thanks very much.
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, no. Whenever we get a parcel here, it's some kind of problem.
Yeah, well, it's probably from Blooming Valda.
It is from Valda. Oh, Joan, look. It's mine from when I was a baby. I've slept in it. Oh. Thought you might like this little bit of family history. Looking forward to seeing you very soon, Valda.
Oh, great. She's coming for a visit. I mean, not that that's it's a lovely present, isn't it?
I'm so surprised. I thought Mum would have thrown it out years ago.
Wonder why Valda held on to it.
No, I mean, she didn't have kids of her own. Maybe she just liked it.
Winnie, she wouldn't have the poodle sleeping in this, would she?
Oh, for heaven's sake, look, it's in beautiful nick.
Oh, well, I guess it's one less thing I have to shell out for.
It won't be a lot of expense, you know. I mean, if that's what you're worried about.
Lenny, all I'm worried about is you, love. That's why I am so angry with Connor and Shelley.
I know, but they'll be all right, won't they? They're sensible kids. They won't. Surely they won't.
Kids, eh? Who'd have them? I mean, this one will be different. I've been talking to this one a lot louder than I talk to the others, and every day, you know,
Joe,
just letting it know
Joe,
what the rules are.
Joe, shut up. Thank you, Alex.
No, well, look, it's been wild the whole time I've been with you.
Same.
You know, I just reckon...
Sorry, hang on. Oh, long distance. Hello? Shell, where are you? Well, just tell me. Look, the longer you leave this, the harder you're going to make it for yourself, okay? So just tell me where you are. I'm coming to get you right now. Michelle, just tell me where you are, okay? Mum and Dad are going crazy.
We're in the country.
You're going to have to do better than that.
Up past Castleton. But you cannot tell Dad, promise me.
Mum and Dad have got every right to know where you are, okay? You're freaking everybody out with your Bonnie and Clyde act.
Hand it over.
Look, she's about to tell me where she is, okay? If you blow your top, we might not hear from her again. Just stay calm, Dad.
Hello, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
What's going on?
Just Harvey jumping up. You know how he is before lunchtime. Okay, right, so you're up past Castleton. Where are you staying?
In this dingy little motel. It's the pits. I think even the fleas are fleas.
Well, come home. We can work this out.
No, look, we're not coming home.
Steph, I really need you to do something for me.
Can you please bring us our passports?
Passport? Where are you going?
Steph, can you please just bring them to us and don't tell Mum and Dad?
Can you do that for me?
Okay, I'll do it.
Thank you so much. Okay, grab a pen and I'll give you directions.
No way. I am not giving you her passport. No way.
Dad, just stay calm.
Yeah,
okay?
You tell me where they are. I will go up and get them and we'll get this mess sorted out.
I promise, Shell. Look, you're going to have to trust me here, okay? I've got an idea.
If
I've got a way.
You do this, Steph, and Shell will end up in Ireland with Connor.
I'm not going to hand over the passports. I will only use them as a bargaining tool, okay?
And what will that do? They'll just take off.
Well, maybe not, Dad, but at least if I can talk to her, I might be able to change her
mind.
There
are a lot of maybes in this plan, Steph.
Yeah, okay, there's a lot of maybes here, but there's one definite too.
What?
The harder you run after Shell, the harder she will run away. Look, she's absolutely terrified, Dad, that she's going to lose Connor. I love you, Dad, but this stubborn streak we've all got, we've inherited from you, okay?
You don't understand, Steph. It's not just Shell and Connor who've got something at stake here. I'm under investigation. If I give you the passports and I'm found complicit, I stand to lose my license, my business and...
Or your daughter. Dad, you got to trust me on this. Hi. Hi.
Thanks for calling up.
I might get us some coffee.
So what's the big deal with the passports?
Well, we've done some checking around and found a place that we can get married without Mum and Dad's permission. That way Connor can stay. He'll be married to an Australian, so that'll make him one too.
I can't believe you're going ahead with this. Where?
New Zealand? Oh. We're flying out as soon as we can. Steph, please, just understand, I never wanted to hurt anyone. Can't you see? Me and Connor going to New Zealand to get married is the only way that we will be able to stay together.
No, Shell, you don't know that. There are appeal processes you can go through with immigration.
Yeah, look, Michelle, I think Stephanie's right.
You're kidding.
No, listen, the immigration department's one thing, but your family's another. I mean, they've been really good to me, you know, and I don't want to repay them by ruining their lives. But that's how it'd feel, okay?
Oh, God. I'm so sorry.
Hey, look, give us his passports and I promise you'll have Michelle home safe and sound.
How can I trust you?
Because you can. Look, Stephanie, I love Michelle with all my heart, okay? And believe me, I would never, ever, ever take her away from you. Believe me.
What you want, isn't it?
Steph, you do understand, don't you?
Oh, Shell, I don't. But if you want to go to New Zealand, then go, okay? I'm not going to stop you. Let's go, Alex. I hope you know what you're doing, Shell.
Go. All sorted?
Yep. Noon flight tomorrow.
I can't believe that we're actually getting married. I'm gonna be Mrs. Connor and you. New Zealand, here we come.
New Zealand?
Why didn't you stop her?
What was I meant to do? Drag her kicking and screaming to the bike? She's not 10, Dad, you know. The more I try and stop her, the further she's going to run.
But why did you give her the passport?
Did you give her the money for the ticket?
No, of course I didn't. But it's going to give Connor time, you know. I think he'll talk sense to Shell.
Oh, you think?
He promised me he'd bring her home.
And you believed him?
Well, Dad, look, I know Connor has stuffed up in the past, but I know that he's got Shell's best interests at heart.
No, if he had Shell's best interests at heart, she'd be home here right now with us.
Yeah, all right. We have got enough troubles without you two at each other's throats.
Look, I know I don't know Connor that well, but he seemed pretty genuine.
I know that, Alex, I know. Look, right now all he's doing is running away, only this time he's got our daughter with him. And all you did was make it easier for him. Yeah, but it's an emergency. You see, she's only 16 and I'm... Yes, look, is there someone else I can speak to? Maybe your supervisor... No, don't put me on hold!
Oh, I told you they wouldn't give you passenger information, love. I mean, they're not allowed to.
You think there's any point in going out to the airport, Lenny?
Well, imagine how many planes go to New Zealand every day.
Well, we've got to do something. Customs. I could ring customs and they'd be able to stop them.
Oh, surely there's another way. Joe, Connor could get into real trouble if you do that.
Yeah, well, right now, Connor's the last on my list of priorities. Let me...
Hi, Mrs. Scully. I was wondering if there's any chores we could do.
Sorry?
We work for nothing.
What's brought this on?
Just being nice.
Dad busted us making prank phone calls, so this is our punishment.
You've been making prank calls?
It was just a joke.
Yeah, well, I'm sure your dad's explained, hasn't he, that it's not such a good idea and...
Yeah. So you got anything you want us to do?
Would you be able to sort of come back tomorrow and we'll try and find something for you then?
Yep, sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
See ya.
See ya.
See ya.
I think that we're having an argument.
Yeah, well, come on, we're in enough trouble as it is.
I really don't want you to call customs, Joe.
Well, you give me one good reason.
Well, shouldn't we trust what Steffi said, that Connor will bring Michelle back? I mean, otherwise we could be getting them into a whole lot more trouble and you could be getting into trouble as well.
Minnie, one of the reasons I'm doing this, love, is to cover my back. I mean, if he goes, then it's his word against mine when immigration come knocking again.
Dad's just like a bull at a gate. He's probably at home calling the SWAT team right now.
Well, he's probably good out of it now. Well, look, you should try living with an Italian family. When I told my pups I was putting off uni, he hit the roof.
Yeah, but see, that's crazy. The more you try and hammer your kids down, the more they're going to rebel. But no matter how many times I try and tell Dad that, he just will not listen to me.
Hey, give the guy a break.
What?
Well, whatever it is you're talking about, it just sounds like Joe's worried. All fathers worry, especially about their daughters.
Yeah,
and God knows what I'm going to be like when Summer gets older.
Thanks very much, Max, but it's not that simple. Michelle and Connor have nicked off to get married.
Oh.
Yeah. So, of course, Dad's being so full-on about it, he's only pushing Shell further away.
Oh, hang on, pretty reasonable thing to get full-on about.
Oh, right. Sounds like you went to the same parenting academy. Overprotect and overreact.
Worrying about your kids is not bad parenting.
No, but putting them in a straitjacket is. Tell you what, I won't be doing that to my kids.
All right, so what'll you do?
I will listen, learn, try to understand what they're going through. Try not to be so out of touch with them.
If only it was that easy. You know, maybe you should just try and respect your dad's point of view.
Heard from them yet?
No, love. I just couldn't sleep, so I was watching the sporting highlights. Yeah, I know Shaw's not an idiot, love, and well, you know, she probably thinks she's in trouble. I know she's in love. Just worried that this is going to get way out of hand.
No. Connor will call Dad. I know he will.
Listen, about before, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I just went off the handle.
Yeah, I think I did a bit of that too. Thanks for going up there. You're still my littlest girl, darling.
To kill. You should amuse me.
Yeah.
You're not having second thoughts, are you?
No, of course not. Why, are you?
No.
Here, do you want a cup of coffee or something?
Yeah, actually, you know what? Some food would be good. I'm really hungry. Hey, maybe we'll go to that coffee shop around the corner.
Yeah. Yeah. I just need to go to the toilet first. So, I'll be back.
Okay. All right.
Hey, Joe, it's Connor.
Where are you?
Well, I'm at the airport. How soon can you be here?
So we'll go to Auckland and we'll hang there for like a week for our honeymoon. It's really scary but really exciting. And then we'll go to Wellington and catch the ferry across to Picton. Sound good?
Yeah, it sounds great.
Will you relax?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Listen, in like 2 hours we're going to be up in the air, in a plane, home free. It's going to work out, okay? God, airports are great for watching people, aren't they?
Qantas flight QF9 to London is now boarding at gate 5. All passengers, please make their way to the departure lounge.
What? What?
That's my flight.
No, that one was to London.
Yeah, I know. I'm going home. I'm sorry, Michelle.
Please don't do this.
Michelle, look, I can't stay here. Look, not after all the mess that I've caused, right? With immigration and your dad's business.
You've still got me and I love you. Does that not mean anything?
Yes, of course. Of course. It means the world to me.
Then how can you just get up and leave like this?
Because it's for the best.
You are not going until we've had this out.
Michelle, I'm not going to be the person that stays here to ruin your life, okay?
If you leave, that's exactly what you're going to do.
Look, even if we did go and get married, right, immigration wouldn't let me back into the country, not after all this mess. Either way, my future's not here.
Just go.
Yeah. Take it.
Michelle, please.
Go.
Michelle.
Dad, the poster must be going blind and ended up at my place.
Oh, thanks. Connor rang.
This is good news?
Well, I hope so. Hey, you wearing your son's new clothes already, huh?
Yeah, actually, they were for me.
I knew that. Why didn't you say so?
Oh, well, you know us guys, we're kind of bashful about our clothes.
Well, there's no need to be. You look really sharp. In fact, any sharper you could slice and dice.
Thanks.
Hey, what about the black spur?
No, you'd probably lose your lunch. We're trying to plan another bike ride. Hopefully this time free of family drama. I think he's a bit nervous about it.
Oh, okay.
You are.
Why not?
Well, thanks, Max.
No worries.
See you later.
Ciao, yeah. Max.
It's an emergency. I have to talk to him before he gets on that plane.
Hi, it's Kerry. Could you please page passenger Connor O'Neill to the service desk? Thanks.
Did you see Michelle? She was just...
You can't get on that plane, son.
Well, you know I can't stay.
Why not?
Joe, do you think this is easy for me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do think it's easy for you. In fact, I think it's one of your specialties, running away when the going gets tough.
Well, I'm only going to get thrown in anyway.
Maybe you will. And maybe you won't. Maybe if you stay and face the music, we can sort this out.
I'll only be putting off the inevitable. Look, Joe, I'm sorry for all the trouble that I've caused you, and with...
Connor, forget all that, son. At the end of the day, the question is, are you going to stand up and be a man? Maybe, son. Maybe you just made a right decision.
I'll bring the...
Oh, did you... Oh, Michelle. Oh, I've been so worried. You silly girl.
I'm sorry, Mum.
Are you all right?
Yeah, just a bit tired, that's all.
Well, you're home, aren't you? You're safe.
Yeah, I've got to go to my room.
No, wait, you've got to have something to eat or...
No, I'm not hungry. I just need to get out of these clothes.
How are you feeling, love?
Yeah. I'm a little bit better.
What, are you sick?
Time for Harvey's walk. Harvey, come on!
Is there anything that you want me to do here?
Yeah, you can stay put until the immigration department get here.
Immigration?
Yeah, there's a bloke coming about 2:30. He said it'll take about an hour and then they can tell you what they're going to do. And don't you even think about
it. I won't.
Won't be long, love.
Harvey, come on! Lynn,
Yeah, Connor! I've had a headache for 3 days now. I'm going to have a lie down.
You were illiterate?
Yeah. Nobody knew. I couldn't read up until recently.
But you can read that document now?
Yeah. I mean, I'd need a bit of help with a few words, but I'm not so bad now. But, I mean, whenever I applied for the visa, I didn't know anything about working restrictions or, 3 months maximum with any one employer. Like, I didn't know anything about them. Like, I didn't have a clue.
Anything further you wish to add?
No.
Bruce, isn't it? Can I say something?
Sure.
I've gone out and got some references from local people, friends of Connor's. I mean, local business people. They will all tell you that Connor is a hard worker and as honest as a day is long. And I've got to say that I agree with every word that's written there.
Thank you, Mr. Skelly.
I can't believe it, so I can stay?
I'm quite satisfied the breach was unintentional.
Oh, thank goodness that's sorted.
You're a lucky boy. Well, thanks again, Bruce.
But we've got our eye on you, Mr. O'Neill, so keep your nose clean. And he can't work for you again in any capacity, okay?
Yeah, I've got you.
Well, not till you get permanent residency, anyway. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks, Bruce.
Joe, I don't know how to thank you. I mean, if you hadn't stepped in like that...
Yeah, and if you had acted like a man instead of an idiot, this might have been cleared up a few days ago. Look, Connor, I'm thankful that you didn't intend to take Michelle with you. And I'm happy for you that you finally stopped and turned around and faced up to things. Make no mistake here, son. I wasn't looking after you. I was looking after Michelle. Michelle and his family... And as for you, worrying your mother and I after death and taking up and leaving at the slightest hint of trouble.
Okay, Dad, this wasn't his fault. I was the one
Michelle.
That...
Connor. Now, as hard as this is, son, you broke your word. And you broke our trust.
And I want you to leave this house as soon as possible.
Right. Well, I'll just go and get my stuff then.
Dad, please don't.
Shell, no.
Dad, this is not fair, okay? It was my idea to up and leave like we did.
Yeah, so you said, Dad.
It's true, though. And I was the one that convinced Connor to take the car.
How you want me to finish the space, Mum?
Thanks, Mum.
Listen, I was afraid that if we came back straight away, the immigration department would take him away or lock him up or something.
Yeah, at this point?
Tough. Connor kept wanting to come back and face up to it. He really did, but I was the one that stopped him. And I was the one that suggested that we get married because if he's married to an Australian...
Michelle, there's no point in going on about it, love. The decision's been made, and that's that.
Mum? Well, can he at least stay tonight? I know that you're really angry with me, but I promise...
Michelle! That's enough. This isn't about you, darling. It's about Connor. It's about Connor and how he breached our trust and our confidence. But while we're on the subject, it's time for a few home truths. You are not the center of the universe. Not everything revolves around you. Shall you? You are no longer the baby of this family. And your mother and I, we can't worry ourselves crazy chasing around. It's time, love. It's time you grew up.
I ain't gonna get going, now. But I just wanted to thank you for everything. I mean, you've been really good to me, and you brought me into your home, and you treated me like one of the family. It's been a really happy time for me, and I just wanted to apologise for letting you all down. So I'm sorry.
Wait. I don't want you to go.
After all I've done, what?
I know, you've really, really hurt me, but I still...
Look, things will be better without me here in the house, all right? I'll phone you and I'll let you know where I'm staying, all right?